The Police Regional Advisory Council has offered 100,000 pesos to those who could give information on the killers of Christine Silawan. An autopsy report showed that the victim was stabbed 30 times.
The horrific terror attack that unfolded in New Zealand overnight. Not one, but two mosques in Christchurch were targeted, the country's worst mass shooting ever. At least 49 people were killed and dozens wounded during services. They were in prayer.
So some of the relatives of the slain mayor who are crying, and I already saw some of the areas which is already cordoned by the authorities who arrived at the area.
Isang lalaki ang patay matapos pagbabarilin ng mga di pa nakikilalang gunmen sa Maynila.
It's a damning indictment of the war on drugs being waged in the Philippines. Amnesty International says the widespread killings of alleged offenders by police and others are a flagrant violation of international human rights law.
South Korean tourist Min Hoon Park only came to the Philippines to play golf. But his leisurely trip turned into a nightmare after he was beaten up. In a complaint he filed at the Korean embassy last January 4.
Safety and security has been one of the problems in our country. We cannot guarantee that safety is in our hands because of such crimes that happens every day. Safety and security challenges rank among the most pressing issues of modern times. Challenges such as cybercrime, terrorism, and environmental disasters impact the lives of millions across the globe. These issues also rank high on the agenda of politicians, international organizations, and businesses.
One is an illegal act for which someone can be punished by an implemented law.
A crime or offense is an act harmful not only to some individual, but also to a community, society, or the state. Such acts are forbidden and punishable by any law. Throughout the years, the constant number of crimes in our country has been increasing.
Murder, rape, robbery, drugs, etc. For the past years, the social justice system has been continuously reforming in order for our law to be changed regarding the rate of crimes.
The top 10 cities with the highest crime rates are still dominated by the cities from Metro Manila, which is the most developed and most populated region in our country. The enactment of ordinances varies per locality, so the PNP does not gauge crime severity by non-index crimes alone. Crime volume comes in handy for the PNP when it wants to determine if crimes are going up or down, regardless of the number of population in an area.
How safe are we? Considering the crimes happening around us, it affects other people, it all treats us with any different thing.
Out of 100%, how safe is the
community?
Is your station is complete with equipment that help handling the cases?
Not totally complete. Masyadong mabilis ang response natin.
Kasi nga, doon sa ating mga communication equipment na kung ikaw ang mga tao dito ay 24-7 na mag-specialist. Mas mabilis kami is sa police. Kahit na sa inyo, ramdamin niyo. Ang police, tumadating pag may kaswati na. Bakit? Meron na dati kita sila na dapat nila nagpilihan. Ilang katulungan nila. Pero ang barangay, ubong ko lang, kung punta na kami agad, siniservisyo na namin ng mga yan. Dahil yung amin na ba, kung barangay lang. Kaya kapag nakita namin, medyo ito ay medyo hindi na pang barangay. Kahit kami ang tumakbo, kahit kami ang nakakuha, kahit kami ang nakahuli, ito ang pasabi namin sa
police. What are the common crimes that happen every day here in
Caloocan? Yan. Lalasing. Yan. Agwawala. Ganyan. Yan. Mga chismis. Pag-uwala. Adindili. Mga suntukan. Rayo. Marami. Yan. Nag-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a- mabilis ang aming response.
From Quezon City and Caloocan City, they can even ensure their own safety.
How do you experience or feeling danger when you go home every night?
Naranasan niyo na po ba umuwi sa gabi na nasa panganib po kayo?
Naranasan?
Oh. Paano mo pa?
Nasa panganib po kayo magkaroon ng tubol sa abon. Ako yung pala yung hati. Hindi ko alam na ako ni Ate pala. Sure po na. Sinaksak ako.
Ay, nakakabla kayo.
Hindi ako yung nabo. Inalok ko nga siya ng ano, kuminong pangalak eh. Of course. Pero ang akin lang, ang nandarap ng pangyayari, ano ba bakit siya, inalakbayan ako. Hindi ko gusto yung panaksak. Diamond style pang ano, pang karabaw. Matay talaga. Kaya, dito lang.
Dahil ay tulak mo po. Hindi naman po.
Do you feel safe here in your community?
Safe po ba kayo dito sa community?
Dito?
Apo. Safe po kayo dito?
Sa akin, safe.
Safe naman po.
Nasa tao yun eh. Nasa tao. Opo. Nasa tao ang paggawa ng bilang isang safe. Nasa tao.
How fast the police responded when you asked for something?
Pag umihingi po kayo na tulong sa mga police, gano'n po sila kabilis po sa
one second.
Sabi, hindi ko pa naganap na humingi ng tulong sa police. Siguro sa ngayon, sa panahon nito, pag-ulis.
Yes,
please.
Yes, I'm feeling danger when you're doing it.
Complicated because even our own justice system cannot comply with such enough measures to sustain our needs of safety and security. There is not enough police visibility, and we always question the government what such things they can do, even there's too much of the policemen needed in such communities. One thing is for sure, the safety we needed begins with us. We must be aware of the things that are happening around us, especially today. We should be alert wherever or whenever we are. Because maybe one day, we, the innocent people, will implore the greatest solution of our safety and security.